In two previous videos, we talked about why a braking resistor is required, how to size one properly, and today we'll talk about how and why a braking resistor needs to be protected from thermal damage. How to protect braking resistors from overheating. As a quick refresher, a braking resistor is connected to the VFD through a simple DC connection. A transistor in the VFD switches on and off to dump energy across the resistor as heat. Now, the danger with using a braking resistor and why it's necessary to protect them from thermal damage is if the braking transistor in the VFD fails closed, there's a constant supply of power going to the resistor. This could ultimately lead to the braking resistor melting or catching fire. The first option to protect the braking resistor is with the use of a thermal switch within the resistor itself. Then when the resistor gets too hot, the switch opens and it's connected to the auxiliary contact of the drive's mainline contactor. This shuts off power to the drive, so even if the transistor fails closed, there's no power going to the resistor. This third diagram shows an intrinsically safe resistor. An intrinsically safe resistor works like a fuse, where if it gets too hot, it fails open so no power can flow across the resistor. The upside of this is that it removes the thermal switch, so there's less wiring involved. The downside is like a fuse, if it fails, it needs to be replaced each time. With the use of a thermal switch, or by using an intrinsically safe option, you can make sure your braking resistor meets UL requirements and protect your cabinet from fire damage. If you have any other additional questions, you can reach us at kebamerica.com or on our social channels.